I'm imagining it's going back middle, Ursa back, Abaddon in the off lane, Ursa Lion in the safe lane. My bet, but honestly, all bets are off right now. Who the hell knows what's going to be happening with, I mean, Axe is the most common mid out of all the heroes that Sluttyouth are running right now, except for the Lion, right? But Lion, the only ranged hero right now in Sluttyouth, kind of doubt he's going to be a car. Don't think that's going to be happening. So, this is awesome. I love it. This is a great start to the day. This is wonderful. All right. We'll have some pauses. So, yeah, I'm imagining it's going to be dual lanes. Bristleback in the off lane. Ursa in the safe lane. I imagine they're going to be doing dual lanes just because... Yeah, Abaddon is a really good support off laner. Like, not quite on the level of Lich. Earthshaker might be a bit stronger than him as well, but Abaddon certainly has his place. It's but entirely. And Tongfu. Well, we're left with a very easy pickup in my mind as their last pick. They're bringing away so many of the highly mobile and anti-melee heroes on Sluttyouth, but there is still one left open, which is the Storm Spirit. So it's it's still going to be tough. Now, they do have a heavy, heavy amount of disables with the lane. And the other highly valuable thing here is that Sluttyouth do have a lineup that's exceptionally tanky. Storm Spirit may not be able to really take advantage of that. He's going to need a lot of mana because he can't just go and jump in and grab a person down, because some hero who can maybe burst down is going to be that Lion. And even that, be sitting in the back, right? He doesn't want to get caught out by the Storm Spirit, as he's pretty much the only disabler versus the Storm Spirit. The Axe is going to be another big disabler as well with the Berserker's Call, but bit harder to land that compared to the instant Hex. Tongfu should be running something pretty simple here to try land mid Storm Spirit and a off Doom. Pretty straightforward there. We're gonna have a smoking. I'm not sure how strong this level one is. I like how they're checking. It's because they know Roshan is going to be checked here, and they're gonna try and catch someone out, but I just don't think they have the power to catch anybody. Like, if they get close enough here, the smoke's been spoiled. First of all, he's gonna run forward, try and bait himself out. Tongfu are smarter than that. They know. Okay, they're like, all right, you were smoked, buddy. We know you have the rest of your team behind you. I mean, the best they could hope for is they managed to get their spot. But, it's pretty interesting. I do like the double thing. I love the Lion because we need a heavy amount of disables, so I think that's pretty strong. Looks like we're going to be running in Ursa middle instead of an Axe middle. And brings it back as a safe lane. Not sure if he's going to be solo, where Lion's going to be at. I don't think it's necessary. Maybe. I mean, it's an Ursa versus a Storm Spirit. It's not going to do wonderful against Storm Spirit. Just, invisibility. Not very matched up for you. And especially with the Shadow Storm pick on the Invis, I said I'm very, very early on the Ursa here. Anyway, so it's going to be the Abaddon with the Axe. I imagine we were going to have the Axe middle, but this offlane makes a lot of sense as well. You just can't. Just like the harassment. Harassing an Axe here is going to be dangerous. If he starts actually getting close enough to spin on you, he's got a shield as well. So they're just going to brute force. This is what the lineup is, just brute force to me. We're just running a whole bunch of melee attacks and running at you.
I think not.
Doom should have a perfectly fine time here. The top lane against the Bristleback. Oh, actually, I like this. Bristleback going for the very, very offensive pickup early on. Viscous Nasal Goo and immediately into the Quills. And this is why Doom has no armor and is real susceptible to this early amount of slow. Lion is waiting until he's going to go. There he goes. Gets out the impale, but it's kind of already too late. Red is already on his way with his first Scorched Earth and is going to be finding a Wolf Commander. So he's actually going to turn around and fight. Oh my god, the first hit critical. Run, oh my god, listen to this. The RNG on this doom. Third hit critical. Do it. Oh my god, no critical, but it was almost. He's gonna kill him. He's actually going to kill him, Lion. Oh my god, first blood. What the hell is this game? Red. What the hell? The clutch double criticals. 20% of a 20% chance. My ass. That did not feel. Oh my god. Just casually doing 150 damage a hit. No problem. No problem. 160 damage or something like that, actually. So my sister's gonna be free for me in the bottom lane. This is the most fun I've had with any of these amateur games so far. This is. Well done, Sluttyouth. I don't even care. I don't even care if this is stopped now. This is already worth it. This is already worth it. 2 minutes in. And we're having first is gonna be pick up the bottom. I actually do like this. Bears suffers from some mana issues quite a bit. With the like the Earthshock, you have a very low mana pool, so I actually like that quite a bit. So this middle build for Nursa is gonna be able to keep up his regen and be actually pretty valuable.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Brisabat going on the Doom once again, this low armor. Still the regen over time. And if he gets a couple criticals here, you gotta Brisabat gotta be careful here. If he gets a critical, just kiting around red. Now he's gonna hell ocean up. This is very smart. He's gonna come back around when he can. Oh god, the Lion! Lion, no! 3 hits is all it takes. He almost brought down from that one. Another Earth Spike is gonna be coming up, and it looks like red should fall here, as he's got nowhere to run to. Gonna be trapped up and taken down. So at least they get some revenge. Well done. 2-2, if you need 3 minutes in. And we're starting out with one hell of a game. So, Zoom, unfortunately, gonna be dying a second time, but still worth it. He got that first vault gold, so that's all that matters. Now he just needs to prime up his Tranquil Boots, and he'll be pretty happy with this lane. And the increase of armor from Tranquil Boots can help you out a lot against this really offensive Bristleback build. And I wonder what the plan is here for Roshan, for Sluttyouth. Because obviously they have an Ursa, they have a ban, they have really good ways to be able to allow the Ursa to tank up Roshan and deal damage with the Ursa. So I'm wondering what their plan, when their ideal timing is going to be for the strategy for Roshan. Because obviously you have to worry about Tongfu, you know, providing some interception here. That's going to happen. There's no way they're going to Roshan over here. Actually, 2 levels of the Viscous Nasal Goo. This is a very curious build, because normally it'd be a 1-3-1 with Bristleback being maxed out later. Sometimes you see players even go for a only 2 levels of Bristleback and then go for the level 3 goo because it provides you that extra tier of minus armor per hit. Lifestealer. Man moving it up against the Axe, trying to force him back as they do a lot of damage to this tower, knowing he's got some healers behind him. He should be fine. Lion's now going to make a rotation into the middle lane. Unfortunately for him, the Storm Spirit has already picked up level 6. I'm not sure if it really... I mean, that time, the Lion can just run through the lane and potentially get the double stables on the Storm Spirit. I'm not quite sure if Ursa has quite enough burst damage to take him down, because Storm Spirit actually starts out with the high amount of armor very early on. Smoking, waiting for the Storm Spirit to come forward, maybe with this last hit. Yep, this is the one. Gets the Hex, follow up with the Earth Spike, and not gonna get it. He's already too far out.
Denied.
And taking a look, I mean, just to see this early gold lead, it's hard to look at early gold lead and make much sense of it. Just because it's such a small lead, it can fluctuate so easily, but it looks like Tongfu are gaining a big advantage. I mean, the kill lead is pretty even, but they're still getting a lot more free farm out of their off lane than I think this dual lane is. The Axe, I don't know, it's just the dazzle of the fact that it makes the Lifestealer be pretty fearless against the Axe, where normally he would play very, very scared, as that physical damage is pretty rough for him to deal with. Rune could be bottom, Lucian's, but Storm Spirit may actually be able to pick it up. Looks like Babu's gonna hold that
one. Spell of three selves.
Or pick it up, you know. Screw Storm Spirit, he doesn't need no goddamn full bomb. Apparently. And we're now going to be happening top lane. Oh man, the courier getting very, very low line, fighting up against Red. Bristleback's coming back, but he actually dies, getting a level there to Doom, who picks up the double kill before he falls to the tower. Fortunately, Axe was able to get an experience range of that one, but still, big win for Red here in the top lane as the Doom just keeps on going ham. Now, Ursa gonna be having some kiting issues, and they actually fall here. Mass teleport's coming out, and U9, well, he's just gonna force those teleports, not even trying to go for the dive or anything else. He's just intent with being able to force these kind of rotations. He's winning in the other way. And now that bottom tier 1 tower will finally fall.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Unable to do much about it. Axe is committing to full iron jungle now. Still, level 6. Who's for 2? Now he's to go for the counter healing as well. Yeah. Ultimate, and with no Doom here, looks like Bristleback thinks he could take this fight. He is getting all that minus armor into Red, but underneath the tower is another question. That maxed out Scorched Earth gives you so much regen over time. Now, the Doom, he immediately went for the Buckler, and I love this build. Maxing out the armor. He's now sitting at 12 armor. Remember when Doom was like, oh, he's got no armor. This goo is going to be doing so much work to him. Not anymore, man. Not anymore. Sitting at 12 armor. When he activates the bristle or the buckler, and with the regen over time, too, Bristleback just cannot take that fight. Tranquil Boots for finish up. Looks like an early smoke with this is the advantage of Ursa nowadays, and it's definitely one of the reasons we're seeing a bump in popularity for him, is that now we no longer have Fury Swipes being a unique modifier, so you no longer have to build up a full Vlads. Unfortunately, this timing is pretty obvious, and the smoke gank is going to be coming in, and Sluttyouth, yep, they're going to be caught out here. The Ursa is done for. Roshan gets the kill. Roshan is pissed, and he actually managed to secure the last hit onto the Ursa. So that was actually pretty favorable for Sluttyouth, all things considered. And looks like they're now going to see into a rotation into the bottom where tier 2 is already under threat. The Abaddon doesn't have his level 6 yet, so he's actually rather close to the Storm Druid's jump. Who have a regen, so he's itching for an excuse to be able to make that long jump in the kill. And Dazzle bursting down this way, Shadow Shaman Ward's being let out.
Whoa, what did I miss?
Yep, the jump in. Abaddon, shield's gonna pop, and they just force him back while the wards are able to take this tier 2 tower.
Bottom tower is under attack.
And Sluttyouth, I mean, say what you will about their man mode lineup, but they do still need farm. They do still need, like, Blink Dagger on the Axe. Bristleback probably needs at least a mech, which is what he's gonna be building here, Buckler, and soon to be a Headrest. And, hell, I mean, Lion needs level 6, the Abaddon needs level 7. They're not ready to fight this early. Unfortunately, the lanes didn't go well for them to take an early advantage and put a stop to these early pushes. Tongfu realized that and are really going to be pushing it now. The middle lanes probably going to be the next target. Storm Spirit's going to be looking around for more ganks. He's got that infested life sealer inside of him. And if they make the jump right now, they could kill the Abaddon. Oh, look at that. Oh, 16 experience points short. He could have lived. 16 experience. What a tragedy.
That
means probably the middle tower is going to go down. Red's committing to the top tower, but they should be able to catch him out here. Max, not going for the call right away. Lion's immediately going to die, and Red should be chopped away, but it's going to be close. Shallow Grave's going to be used, but it doesn't really matter up against the Axe. He needs to be able to get that cooling blade, but unfortunately, Red's just tanking up too much. Now the mech goes off. He's going to be able to keep above that kill threshold as the Axe falls. Middle tower taken down. Top tower is going to be denied, but still, they got the Axe. They killed the Lion and got him middle tower. Yeah, this is snowball. Who are currently only sitting, the net worth wise, 2,900 net worth on the Ursa. Four other heroes are way ahead of him on the side of Tongfu.
Dire's top tower has been
there goes
denied.
That mid tower, but we do have the rotation coming in once again. Unite looking for that jump. It's going to be going straight for the Ursa. Finds him, and the Abaddon still helps out a little bit. Unfortunately, not nearly enough against these five heroes. And now the Abaddon will go down as well. Use his teleport, and that means he's going to fall. Maybe if he had a teleport, he could have used it after that leash from the Storm Spirit and gotten out in time, but
Radiant's
just not the case. And I fear we're going to be seeing a very, very early GG call here from Sluttyouth. least they can counter some wards. At least they got that under control. Brisbane can chase away by Lifestealer. This is not, like, this really shouldn't happen. Lifestealer shouldn't be able to chase away at Bristleback. That's just no. Another tower gonna fall this time. It's tier 2 at the top lane. We probably committed his wards.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
I don't know, man. This is like... This whole entire strategy feels like it was banking on some, like, Roshan action. Catching out somebody in first blood. Getting Roshan... Having lanes go really well, I have no idea, but they just can't do anything for the next 10 minutes. And in those 10 minutes, Tongfu are going to take such a hold of this game, are going to be so far ahead in net worth, top 5 in the net worth, all Tongfu heroes now. The Dazzle is above the Bristleback. Well, when he drops his Arcane Boots, maybe not, but... We're gonna have a very fast Agnes. As you can see, a Storm Spirit. Doom is gonna be placed on the axe. They're gonna try and burst him first and then kite around the earth as it goes. This is just straight up running away. Then Midas Armor starts taking into play very quickly. Gonna be able to take him down. Meanwhile, the rest of the team is coming in. Shadow Shaman. He's gonna be saved by the Shell Grave. Dazzle's not gonna be as lucky. And they turn around, kill off the Shadow Shaman. But the cores are here for Tongfu. And this is just clean up on aisle 3. A Baton's gonna go down. Bristleback's gonna be the last one left alive for Sluttyouth. And fortunately for him, the Storm Spirit doesn't have enough mana to chase him down. But he will have an Orchid very, very soon. Oh, man. 13 minutes in, 15-5, 14,000 in gold lead for Tongfu. Almost a 7,500 experience lead. And they haven't even tried to go uphill yet. SNY for the Doom. Armlet gonna be up for the Lifestealer.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
And the Orchid for the Storm Spirit. In fact, I gotta mention the Dazzle here, who I thought was the Shadow Shaman. Oh, Shadow Shaman. He's gonna be picking up the eggs. And in fact, he's one third of the way there. So with an Aegis, Storm Spirit can just jump in, probably kill two people in the process before he goes down. Comes back up with an Aegis. The rest of the team is there to make the commitment. Yeah, pretty simple stuff. Oh, forget about the infested Lifestealer inside of the Storm Spirit. Can't forget about that one. Yeah, extra bit of burst damage. Probably three heroes dying within that first land of the Storm Spirit. As Lifestealer's gonna go up another. And they're gonna go for the Bristleback here in the bottom lane. He does have a mech, but he doesn't have maxed out Bristleback. He went for that level 3 goo, which gives you that extra armor tick. That only works when you're ahead. If you're doing really well in your laning phase and you're like, okay, I picked up like an 8-minute Vanguard, I'm impossible to kill anyway, I don't really need the extra tank from Bristleback, then yes, that's when you start going for the Viscous Nasal Goo over the Bristleback being maxed out. Get that to level 3. Don't max it out to level 4. Just level 3. Get that extra armor loss. Because at level 3, it takes down 2 armor per tick. You're going to be able to jump in. The Baton Shield will be able to protect Yurza against the Orchid and a lot of the damage. And now the Axe jumps in strong. He's going to be done. Oh, he even misses it. The heal's coming out just in time. And he can't even take the Aegis away from the Storm Spirit. He's now going to go on the Lion. And the Bristleback's going to stick out from the Doom. And a perfect wipe. Nobody dying for Tongfu. Not even losing the Aegis. And that's going to be tier 3. And without a doubt.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Still, though, they provide some serious entertainment. Red going completely bonkers with that critical strike. Who does that? Who does that? Picks up critical strike and immediately gets 2 crits like that. Some bullshit. I would be so pissed if I was that Lion.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Storm Spirit gonna be infested once again, and thanks to all the Orion and Arena, he's ready to go. Yeah, hitting the Bristleback back doesn't really matter too much. It's just an AoE there. The best pop out in the Storm Spirit, with his one static remnant and auto attack. Insane. 4 heroes go down. Bristleback teleports back to base inside of his base. That's when you know. That's when you know real, true terror. And GG will be called as the second set of racks go down. So. Well done by Tongfu, I guess. Sluttyouth, unconventional drafts, not working out so much. And